Thank you for joining me for another installment of the Bob Sullivan Show. Bob Nation, I hope you're ready for a terrific guest, one of my favorites, Sam Frei. How you doing, Sam?
I'm doing good. Thanks for inviting me to talk on the show.
Yeah, no problem. How's life in Hastings, buddy?
Life's good here. I'm here to go see my family. I just spent the weekend up in Omaha with some friends and stuff, but school's been good and everything, so yeah.
Good. How's baseball treating you?
Baseball's going well. We had a good fall. The weather was great for the fall, but my team was in the championship of the Fall Classic.
Oh, okay.
How
are you competing up there? What's the outlook for you being a freshman?
Well, I did not make the J-term practice team, which is like the team that practices right now, which is like the varsity.
Right.
But I'm feeling pretty good. I know what I got to work on and stuff, so I've been working hard this month, so hopefully when the actual season comes along, I do well and they bump me up.
What is your outlook right now as far as what positions will you be playing, or do you know that yet, or are you going to move around?
When I first got here, they said I'd be pitching and catching, but now it's just going to be pitching.
Okay.
And I'm assuming starting, like a starter pitcher and not a closer, so.
Okay. What have you learned about yourself baseball-wise early on that you need to improve on to be a college baseball player?
Discipline, really. Like, in high school, during January, we were mandatory to go do these workouts and stuff, but now everyone who didn't make the J-term practice team is really on their own until the end of January, so it's really on us to go work out and play catch and pitch and stuff, so.
So you're basically right now you're kind of practicing individual practices to see who really wants it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
What was your biggest wake up call during the fall that you had when you started with baseball?
It's a little bit of a funny story. So, the first couple days of practice, the practices were just scheduled, like, just how they were laid out was a ton different. Everyone was always doing something.
Right.
And you had to look at the practice schedule before practice and know exactly where you're supposed to be and stuff. So that was a big wake-up call. But then, nicknames. I had the nickname Hoover for a little while, and for certain reasons.
You don't want to get into those?
I will. It doesn't matter to me.
If you want to get into them, well, we got an audience that would love to hear them. If you want to open that up, if not, we can keep those under wraps.
Well, I'll get into it. It's me. It's funny. It was about the second or third week of practice, and I had been with this girl the night before.
Right.
And so I had a bruised-looking object on my neck.
Okay.
And it was a rather large one. It looked like I had just been punched. And so I got to practice the next day, and all the players were just laughing and making fun of me. But then when coach was reading off the list of names where people were supposed to be, I didn't hear my name. So I was like, hey, coach, you didn't read my name off, where am I supposed to be? And he goes, no, I read your name, Hoover. And I go, what? Coach, that's not my name. He's like, sorry, you know what Hoovers are famous for? I'm like, what, coach? They're famous for sucking. Well, go shag me out, Bill.
Oh, God. Your girlfriend find out about that one, or is that your girlfriend?
It was her. She knew about it. Yeah.
Oh, God. She must have been pretty proud of that.
Yeah, I was pretty angry.
Did what was your pitching in college? Did when I was at Mount Marty, we were called the Tard Hatch if you're a pitcher, because basically you did your sit-ups and all your core exercises. You ran and then you shagged in the outfield, and nobody was athletic in the Tard Hatch. How have you adjusted to having to shag fly balls for a lot of practices, or have you been pretty active during those practices?
It's been tough because we've had some long practices, so I've been stuck shagging for a while. But I've, just joking around, messing around, the usual, wasting away time. I usually make a little basketball game out of the bucket, so I usually get on the bucket and then see how far I can go back and shoot hoops.
The older guys, the veterans at Hastings, have they gotten used to the dipshit Sam Frei is that I came to know and love?
Yeah, very well. Some of the older pitchers, at least, I really like. They're a lot like me, and they can put up with my retardedness.
Right. What's the best part of practice that you turn into kind of a game?
Best part of shagging, did you say?
The best part of practice that you kind of turn into a game for yourself. Like, I mean, Ron Colley, I mean, me and you always used to dick around, even though I was a coach and you were the player. We would dick around during the practices, but what's one of your favorite things to do at practice that you screw around on?
Let's see. Probably just during drills and stuff, like when we're shagging, just walking around with people and just telling them some stupid stuff and see if I can get them to believe.
How many players have quit since you guys have gotten started, or have they thinned the herd a little bit as far as players?
Yeah, there's a few juniors and seniors that didn't make the J-term practice team, so they quit, but it's probably just about 5 to 6.
You guys play at Duncan, which is Duncan Field, for your fans out there. In Hastings, the greatest baseball park in Nebraska, maybe in the country, but have you given up a home run yet there at Duncan, or has anybody hit a home run yet from Hastings?
We actually haven't. We've been the big softball complex with the baseball field, and that's where we've been practicing, and that's where we did all our fall ball stuff.
Okay, but you guys will be on there for the regular season, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes, and then actually after this year, it's because it'll be remodeled, so like the stands and stuff are getting redone, and it's going to be pretty cool.
Good shit. I hope they don't mess with that brick wall, because that is sweet out there.
Yeah. No, they're leaving the brick wall. I have seen the plans.
Are they going to redo? I hope they redo the clubhouse for you guys, because that's an eyesore.
Yeah.
Are they redoing that?
Yes, they are. So hopefully we'll have more than one toilet, and we'll actually have a stall.
Oh, yeah. I had a uncomfortable experience of sweat sitting on the toilet and not being able to force one out there on a 99 degree, 100% humidity day there. where do you see your potential right now for your Hastings career, or what do you think you can accomplish there?
Well, it might be a little bit of a long shot, but by the end of this season, maybe being at least traveling with the varsity.
Yeah.
Because the JV only plays, it's not like 9 to 10 games or something.
Okay.
So, I'm probably not going to get too many pitchers, because we have quite a few pitchers that'll be on JV. But hopefully, Philly. And then, if that happens, the J-term practice team next year. Hopefully be on varsity from there.
Now you've had a bit of a strange career as far as your high school. I mean, I always thought you were a really good player, but, I mean, you got a little, not hosed, but you weren't as appreciated at West Side as you should have been because you were a really good player. Then you come over to Roncalli, and, I mean, immediately, I know all those guys like you. You're the jackass of the team, and who can't like that guy? But do you feel you're better prepared than maybe some of your fellow? You've had to deal with a lot of adversity on the field as far as not you're maybe the you've been the last guy picked, so to speak. You've had that feeling. So, do you feel like you're better prepared for handling adversity at the college level than, say, maybe some kid that's come from a Blair or Wahoo or something who was the best player in the town, and now they're on JV and they don't know how to deal with that not being the best anymore. How well are you fitting in as far as understanding your role and being able to except maybe something that the better players on that the better players from different towns are dealing with their failures. How have you noticed any differences between you and them?
Yeah, I definitely have. Because my junior spring at Westside, I was still JV and I was catching them, and then I got cut. And
right.
My coach told me that you're going to have to pitch if you want to play and here at least. So I said, I'll go on Cali and play and learn how to pitch there. But, so that just kind of, because at first I was just going to stop playing ball and be done. So I was done for about a week. And I had gotten a job and I was going to work all summer. And then I was just I can't do this. I miss baseball way too much. So that's how I ended up at Roncalli. But that taught me a lot because when I was looking, that coach told me I was done. I wasn't going to be able to play for Westside. It killed me. And I was just I'm not going to let some coach who doesn't know exactly how well I can pitch because he's never seen me pitch say that I can't play. So I'm going to go and I prove myself and I learned and I made the team my senior spring. And I don't know if I would have made it my senior summer or not, because I was just I'm done, I'm not even going to try it. I want to go back to Roncalli and play. I went to there.
Right.
Playing for Goofer, loved Shep and you, and loved all the guys and everything, but being here and going through all that, it's helped me a lot, because I don't know if I would have not made the J-term practice team, not going through all that stuff. I don't know how I'd be feeling right now, because right now, I'm just feeling all right, I didn't make it.
Yeah.
Not a big deal. It's my freshman year. If it was my senior year, that would be a little different, but
yeah.
It's my freshman year. I'm just going to work my butt off, do everything I can, and get as good as I can, and say, hey, coach, here's what I got to offer.
Who was in the running for the recruit, Sam Frei, that you had? Did you have to make any phone calls to any other baseball coaches to tell them, hey, man, thanks for recruiting me, but I'm going to Hastings. And how awkward were those if you had to make those?
I made a couple. I call it Cornell in Orange City in Iowa somewhere.
Okay.
Their coach was talking to me. And that was kind of an awkward conversation because I was just coach, he's been calling me for a couple of days and I'd always miss him here or there. I wasn't ignoring him, but I just wanted to get the time to talk to him. So we'd take messages and then I finally talked to him and it was just I'm going somewhere else. And he's all right, well, thanks, bye.
Yeah.
It was a little because, you know, I wasn't going to go there, so.
Dick.
And then, I can't remember the other schools. There was like one or two other schools.
Do you, did you guys get to play any, did you play all inter-squad games so far? Or have you personally been able to play any, fall games against, any other college teams yet?
We played against, I can't remember what team it was. It was one, I can't remember which one it was, but they weren't good at all. They only had about 8 or 9 guys.
Right.
So we actually had to give them a pitcher for a few innings, but I pitched one inning against them and I did well, but all the other games we played in, the freshmen, were against, like, UVA's teams and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
They actually played against the prestigious Matt Shepard's team.
That's right. Did you beat them?
We didn't keep score, but yeah.
How did you adjust, to the fall baseball there? Because, I know that's sometimes a difficult thing to get used to is, essentially, you're playing against another team, but essentially you're playing against your teammates who you're playing with,
mm-hmm.
which if you've never played in an atmosphere like that, it's a tryout, but it's not, but it's almost like, at certain points you're almost rooting against, like, if you're a selfish asshole, you're going to be rooting against somebody who you're competing with to maybe get that last spot on the varsity team or whatnot. How did you adjust to that? Because I know a lot of college baseball players have trouble adjusting to that when they're freshmen.
Yeah, it was definitely new. I had never even played ball before either, so it was new. And especially because we didn't get to know everybody because we have 2 different times that people would practice before we started playing games. So
right.
I could have been practicing and not even have met a kid that's even on the team as a freshman. And so when it came to games, when we started playing, I'd see kids that never had even seen before. And so no one really knew each other very well. So I think that made it almost a little bit easier to kind of root that way, as you were saying.
Right.
Not that that's good, but...
Wait, but, everybody... Everybody... you want the best for the team, but you also want to be on the team, right? People look at it as selfish, but, if you're thinking... you don't want to see somebody fail, but... Yeah, it's the competitive nature of baseball. How quickly do you feel like your personality fits the personality of the team, or do you feel like is the personality of the team pretty laid back, or what's the personality of Hastings Baseball?
It's a lot like Ron Colley is, like, for the kids. We're all pretty laid back. We all get along pretty well. There's a few kids that stand out that, not my athletic wise, but that kind of get on people's nerves. But, every team will have that. So,
well, those guys can kind of unite or divide the team. If everybody kind of, it's like the everybody's against that guy. It can kind of bring them together, or if they're too divisive, it can just ruin the team. What do you see, or what is the, what's your coach's name?
Jim Bovey.
Okay. What has he said to you that you need to work on to be a contributor for Hastings this year and for the future?
Our players' meeting, most of the freshmen did, and in that meeting we talked about, he actually did not mention anything about hitting too many batters.
Okay.
So So that was really happy about that because I had a little issue with that.
Yeah.
But he did tell me that when I'm in the stretch, I tend to be a little less accurate, and I need to work on holding runners on and keep them from getting extra bases.
Right. Where are you right now as far as catching? Are you are you doing that at all, or are you strictly pitching now?
No, I don't even have my catcher's gear here anymore. My brother took it home because I talked to him, and he said, you know, we have plenty of catchers,
right.
So we're just going to focus on pitching for you.
Good. Okay. And also, have you gotten used to not hitting at all? And do you like?
It was weird because, well, for the first 2 or 3 weeks, I was hitting.
Right.
And then randomly my name just got dropped out of the hitting list. So I was like, okay, that's fine. I'll just get shagged all day.
Who doesn't like shagging all day?
Oh, I know. Get some feeds and just chill.
You stand right now as far as, or where Hastings stands right now, what's the potential for your team? Do you think a GPAC title is possible, or do you know anything about where you guys are?
I think it's very possible. We returned a lot of pitchers, and a lot of our pitchers were young.
Right.
So we did lose Tops, who was a really, really impactful catcher from last year. So the catcher spot, I think, is going to be the biggest loss. But other than that, I think we're going to be good. I think we got a shot at the GPAC.
Who's the leader of the team? Who do you look up to, and whose example do you follow?
I really look up to, his name's Kirby Wells. He came from Grand Island Senior High. I actually knew him before I came here because family, friends, and all this stuff. But he's really, like, he's just taken charge. He hasn't been, like, the typical upperclassman who's kind of just a dick to everybody and hazes and everything. He's really taken me and a few other guys under his wing and pushed us along and helped us. So I look up to him, and he was at least from what I heard from last year, the ace. So, yeah.
It's prediction time.
All right.
Where will you be by the end of the season? What are you going to be on JV? Or are you going to be a are you going to reach, get a varsity spot for the GPAC tournament? What's your prediction for where you'll be? Actually, let me make that, I'll go prediction.
Okay. Well, I'd like to have a spot to at least travel with the varsity, but I know for sure I'll be one of the top pitchers on the JV. So I think I have a pretty good shot at that.
So do you think it's realistic you could get on the squad for the tournament or be a travel player?
I think there's a potential for it. There's a few pitchers who have been having some arm issues this fall. So if their arms don't get any better, that gives me a little bit more of a chance. But, I mean, I'm not rooting for them not to get better, but that's just what's going on.
Where do you guys finish in the, another prediction, where does Hastings finish as far as regular season goes? You guys will finish? Middle of the pack or top of the pack in the GPAC?
I think we'll be close to the top of the pack.
Okay.
I think we got a pretty good team. Our pitching staff is strong this year. I think we only lost one guy from last year. So, I think we'll be top of the pack.
And last one, who wins the GPAC title and gets a spot in regionals?
I'd like to say Hastings. You
can say Hastings.
Got a good shot. I think it'll be close. Hastings and Don's got a pretty good team.
Okay. They've come out of nowhere. When I was looking at schools, they were a 4-6-8 win team. Their rise has been pretty big as far as GPAC goes.
They got a kid. I don't know if you know him. He played at Westside with me, Brandon Stennis.
Okay.
He was going to go to Wayne State on a scholarship, but they weren't going to give him quite enough money he needed, so he actually went to Doan, and he's in the rotation, I guess, on varsity. So he's going to have a pretty big role for them. So
well,
that'll help him a lot.
All right, the last thing I wanted you to do before we go. I've already interviewed Jason Schmidt from Mount Marty. I want you to talk some smack to Mount Marty. Actually, just talk smack to Jason Schmidt. He's their best player. He's their, he's probably going to get drafted. I want some smack talk between you two.
What position does he play?
He's a shortstop and their closer.
All right. Shoot, I don't know.
Nothing? Here, I'll help you out.
Okay.
Say, any guy that lives with three women in relationships is a patsy.
Whoa. He lives with three women and they're all in relationships?
Yeah, but he's in a relationship with one of them, but the other two are in relationships.
I was about to ask him who his boyfriend is.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's been in question sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
But, we'll have to start a little rivalry between you two before the season's
all right.
Over. Also, I'd like to honor you with the fourth spot, officially, on the All Bob Sullivan Show team.
Thank you.
I'd like to give you the righty reliever. Would you accept that role?
I would graciously accept that.
All right, that's good stuff. Because I got Bercher at starting pitcher, you as my righty reliever, and then Mike Novak from Kearney at second base, and what's his name? Jason Schmidt at short. So I'll put you as my righty reliever for right now.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. And I'm going to, assuming this show doesn't get canceled, hopefully the Hastings support. Yeah, hopefully you can help me with some Hastings support.
For sure. I'll
set up a little Sam Frei tribute for your player profile, and I'll load your... put your stats and let me know when you guys have games, and I'll put a schedule in there, and your friends or whatever can follow Hastings Baseball on there and how you're doing.
Awesome.
So, yeah, just let your friends know to check that out, and I'll do that. And also, if I can keep, if there ever gets to be a money flow, I'm going to do a Bob Sullivan Show bus, like the bus that travels around for ESPN. And I'm going to travel to different athlete guests that I've had on. So, like you, Schmitty, Novak, I'll visit all the campuses, take a look at the game, and get an in-person interview for this show.
That'd be awesome.
So, yeah, tell Hastings to talk it up, and I'll make a trip out there if I can get the bus going.
Okay.
So, is there anything else you want to talk about before we go here?
I just got one thing to say. everybody listening, go check out the book that I just published about a week ago.
You did?
Yeah.
What's that one?
It's called The Lucky Few Growing Up with a Learning Disability.
Okay.
It's because I'm dyslexic, so it's just about dyslexia and about how it's not the end of the world and that a lot of famous actors, Einstein was actually dyslexic. He was pretty smart guy. I'm not saying I'm as smart as him, but I'm pretty damn close.
But yeah, you got the pieces there. You just got to put them together.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, so, I didn't know you wrote it yourself?
Yeah, I wrote it. It was actually for my senior project in high school.
Really?
Then my uncle's an author, so I talked to him, and it got published about 2 weeks ago, so.
Well, you know what? I'll talk that up on the here. Send me a cover or whatever, and I'll put it up on the show page. I'll advertise it for you. No problem.
Awesome, thank you. I do have a Facebook page for it. So.
Okay, yeah, I'll hook up a link or just hook up whatever to that. And what's the name of it again? The Lucky Few.
The Lucky Few.
All right.
Growing up with a learning disability. So.
All right. Yeah, I'll have to check that out. I'll read it. I'll advertise the shit out of it. So that's good stuff. Sammy. Well, I'm glad you could come on. We'll do a little bit of cross promotion for the show and the book.
And, sounds great.
Yeah. So you send people my way. I'll send people your way, and I'll take a look at that book. That's good stuff.
Perfect. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem. Congratulations on the book. Congratulations. Good luck with the season, and I look forward to talking to you soon.
Thank you.
Yep, no problem. Sam Frei, everybody. Thank you for joining us for another edition of the Bob Sullivan Show, and look forward to having Sam Frei on again. Bye. Hey, Sam.